फ्रेंड्स, हाय एवरीवन, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू माय चैनल कंप्लीट मैथ्स बाय बालाजी। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लुक पार्ट 26 ऑफ रेशन प्रोपोर्शन इज अबाउट मिसेलेनियस प्रॉब्लम्स। ओके, यस, मिसेलेनियस क्वेश्चन नंबर 7। इन पार्ट 25 ऑफ रेशन प्रोपोर्शन वी डिस्कस्ड 6 क्वेश्चंस एंड इन दिस पार्ट वी स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 7th क्वेश्चन। ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 7। C1, C2, C3, C4 and C5 are the 5 companies. The profit made by C1, C2 and C3 are in the ratio 9:10:8, while the profit made by C2, C4 and C5 are in the ratio 18:19:20. If the profit difference between C5 and C1 companies is 19 lakhs, then find the profit made by all companies. C1, C2, C3, C4 మరియు C5 అన్నవి 5 కంపెనీలు. C1, C2, C3 ల యొక్క లాభాలు నిష్పత్తి 9:10:8. C2, C4 అండ్ C5 కంపెనీల లాభాల నిష్పత్తి 18:19:20. C5 కంపెనీ లాభం C1 కంపెనీ లాభం కన్నా రూపాయలు 19 లక్షలు ఎక్కువైన 5 కంపెనీల యొక్క మొత్తం లాభం ఎంత? సొల్యూషన్: the ratio of company 1, company 2 and company 3 are in the ratio 9:10:8, and the ratio of profit made by companies 2, company 4 and company 5 are in the ratio 18:19:20. So we have to find the profit made by all companies, company 1, company 2, company 3, company 4 and company 5 equal. Since C2 is connecting term, C2 is our connecting term. So we have to equate the value of C2. Okay. So consider LCM of 10, 18 is 18 into 5, that is 90. So to make it 90, multiply first ratio by 9. And multiply second ratio by 5. Okay. So that C1 value 9 9s are 81. Is CT value 9 10s are 90. C3 value 9 8s are 72. And C4 value 5 19s are 95. And C5 value 5 20s are 100. And given that the profit difference between company 5 and company 1 is 90 lakhs. Difference between company 1 and company 5 are 8100. 100 minus 81, that is 19 units. 19 units value is 19 lakhs. Then 1 unit value is 1 lakh. So we have to find the profit made by all companies. Sum of the ratios are equal to. Okay. Unit is in place. Add them. 0, 5. 5 plus 2, 7. 0, 7 plus 1, 8. Units plus 8. Now add tens place. 0 plus 9. 9 plus 7. 16. 16 plus 9. 25. 25 plus 8. 33. 3 carry. 100 plus 3 plus 1. 4. Yes. 438 units value is 1 unit value 1 lakh. Then 438 units value is 438 lakh. But answers are in the crores. So it can be written as 4.38 crore. Therefore, profit made by all 5 companies is 4.38 crores. Next, second question. Very important question. Trending question nowadays for competitive exams. A boy and a girl playing with the pencil. The girl breaks the pencil into 2 parts. And the boy observes that the ratio of length of these 2 parts is same as the ratio of length of pencil to the larger part. Find the ratio in which the girl breaks the pencil. ఒక బాలుడు మరియు బాలిక పెన్సిల్ తో ఆడుకుంటున్నారు. బాలిక ఆ పెన్సిల్ ను పెద్ద భాగం చిన్న భాగాలుగా విడగొట్టింది. ఆ భాగాలను బాలుడు గమనించి వాటి నిష్పత్తి ఆ పెన్సిల్ మరియు పెద్ద భాగంలో నిష్పత్తికి సమానమని తెలిపాడు. అయినా బాలిక విభజించిన భాగాల నిష్పత్తి ఎంత? సపోజ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ఎ పెన్సిల్. ద గర్ల్ బ్రేక్ ద పెన్సిల్. This is larger part and this is smaller part. Idi pedda bhagam chinna bhagam. Let us suppose length of larger part be x units and length of smaller part be 1 unit. Okay, let us suppose length of larger part be x units, small part be 1 unit. What is the length of total pencil? X plus 1 unit. This is the length of total pencil. Boy observed here, boy observed that larger part ratio to smaller part ratio is equal to length of pencil to the larger part. Length of pencil is x plus 1 unit and length of larger part is x unit. Yes, what is the length of larger part? That is x by smaller part 1 unit equal to x plus 1 by x. By cross multiplication, what we get? X into x, x square equal to x plus 1. X square, take x plus 1 terms into LHS, minus x minus y equal 0, which is a quadratic equation. Which is a quadratic equation. Yes, we know that a quadratic equation general form is ax square plus bx plus c equal 0. So compare these two equations, what we get? A equal to 1. A equal to what? 1. As x square coefficient is a, here x square coefficient is 1. Similarly, compare b, b equal to what? Minus 1 and c equal to minus 1. To find the roots of this quadratic equation, we have a formula by Sridharacharya formula. It is known as famous formula, Sridharacharya's formula. Minus of b plus or minus under root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Minus b plus or minus under root of b square minus 4ac. That is x equal minus. What is b value? B value minus 1 plus or minus under root of b square minus 1 square minus 4 into a value minus plus 1 and c value minus 1 by 2a. 2 into a value is 1. Which is equal to x equal to what? Minus of minus plus 1 plus or minus minus 1 square plus 1 minus 2 minus plus 4 1s are 4. That is 1 plus 4, that is 5 by 2. What are the roots? That is 1 plus root 5 by 2 comma 1 minus root 5 by 2. Since root 5 value is approximately 2.236. Root 5 value is 2.236. So 1 is less than the root 5. So we will get this value negative. But length of the any item is not negative. So omit the 1 minus root 5 by 2. So we consider length of larger part is 1 plus root 5 by 2. Yes, then we have to find the ratio of which girl breaks the pencil, that is x is to 1. Girl breaks the pencil into x is to 1. What is x value? 1 plus root 5 by 2 is to 1. So multiply both the terms by 2, we get 1 plus root 5 is to 2. So answer is 1 root 5 plus 1 is to 2. So answer is C. This can be written as root 5 plus 1 is to 2. Okay. Next question, 9th one. In a zoo, there are rabbits and pigeons. If heads are counted, there are 340 heads. And if legs are counted, there are 1060 legs. How many pigeons are there? ఒక జంతుశాలలో కుందేళ్లు మరియు పావురాలు ఉన్నాయి. వాటి తలలను లెక్కిస్తే 340 ఉన్నాయి, మరియు కాళ్ళను లెక్కిస్తే 1060 కాళ్ళు ఉన్నాయి. అయినా ఆ జంతుశాలలో గల పావురాల సంఖ్య ఎంత? సొల్యూషన్ దిస్ మెథడ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ షిఫ్టింగ్ మెథడ్. If heads are counted, heads are 340 and if legs are counted, that is 1060. And we know that among 1060 legs, each rabbit carries 4 legs and each pigeon carries 2 legs. Okay? Yes. Let us suppose there are 340 pigeons in the zoo. Let us suppose there are 340 pigeons in the zoo. Let us suppose there are 340 pigeons in the zoo. Then number of legs, number of legs are equal to 340 pigeons. Each pigeon has 2 legs. So total legs are 680. But total legs are counted as 1060. How many extra legs are there in the zoo? Extra legs equal 1060 minus 680. That is 0, 8, 380 legs. Extra legs are 380. Okay. Therefore, number of rabbits number of rabbits equal total eggs by it has two legs extra, so divided by 2, that is 190 rabbits are there. Therefore, number of pigeons equal number of pigeons equal total heads are 340 minus number of rabbits 190, which is equal 150 pigeons are there. So answer is B. And allegation method. Method 2. Solution by method 2. Suppose 340 pigeons are there, then total legs are 680. Use allegation on legs above. Use allegation on number of legs. Suppose, let us suppose total are pigeons, then what are the number of legs for pigeon? 340 into 2, 680. And suppose total are rabbits, 340 rabbits are there, let us suppose, then 340 into 4, that is 0, 16, 1360 legs for all rabbits. But the given that there are 1060 legs in the zoo. By allegation method, we get that 1360 minus 1060. We get the ratio of rabbits to pigeon. That is 1360 minus 1060. That is 300. And 1060 minus 680. That is 340. The ratio between these two is 0, 0, 2 17s, 2 15s. So, a rabbit is to pigeons in the zoo is 7 is to 15. That is sum of the your ratio is 34 units. 34 units total heads are 340. So, 1 unit is 10. Then, number of pigeons are 15 units. 15 tens are 150. Number of pigeons are 150. Okay. Next question. 10th one. A girl purchased 1 dozen bangles one day. She slipped on the floor and fell down. What can be the ratio of broken to unbroken bangles? Okay. What cannot be the ratio of broken to unbroken bangles? ఒక బాలిక 1 dozen గాలికి కొన్నది. అనుకోకుండా ఆ గాలు చేదారి కింద పడ్డాయి. అయినా కింది వాళ్ళు పగిలే కామ పగలని గాలు నిష్పత్తి కానిది ఏది? Okay. Suppose, what is 1 dozen means? 1 dozen equal 12 bangles. So, broken, unbroken parts. So, the broken, unbroken parts. Since number of bangles are, always integer. Positive integer. That number of bangles cannot be 1.5, 2.5, 3.5. Number of bangles are always positive integer. That is 1 bangle or 2 bangle, 3 bangle, 10 bangle, 12 bangles, 20 bangles. Like that. Okay, let us suppose ratio of broken to unbroken B, A is to B. Let us suppose broken to unbroken is A is to B. Then A plus B, sum of the ratio is a factor of, sum of the ratio is a factor of 12. Since, let us check by options. 1 plus 2, 3, yes, is a factor of 12. 1 plus 3, 4, is a factor of 12. 1 plus 5, 6 is a factor of 12. But 2 plus 3, 5 is not a factor of 12. So, the broken to unbroken ratio cannot be 2 is to 3. Okay, as 2 plus 3, 5 cannot divide the 12. Next, very important question. Most important. Two candles with same length light up at same time. First candle ending 8 hours and second candle ending 6 hours. Rate of burning is different for the both candles. After the start burning, after how much time ratio of their length will be 3 is to 1. Okay. Samana podulu gala rendu kovvottulanu oke sari veliginchaaru. మొదటి కొవ్వొత్తి 8 గంటలు, రెండవ కొవ్వొత్తి 6 గంటల వరకు వెలగగలవు. కానీ వాటి మండే సామర్థ్యాలు వేరువేరుగా ఉన్నాయి. అయినా ఆ రెండు కొవ్వొత్తులను ఒకేసారి వెలిగించిన ఎంత సమయం తర్వాత వాటి పొడవుల నిష్పత్తి 3:1 అవుతుంది. ఓకే, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఫస్ట్ క్యాండిల్, దిస్ ఈజ్ సెకండ్ క్యాండిల్. ఫస్ట్ క్యాండిల్ కెన్ బర్న్ 8 అవర్ అండ్ సెకండ్ క్యాండిల్ కెన్ బర్న్ 6 అవర్. లెట్ అస్ సపోజ్ లెంగ్త్ ఆఫ్ ది క్యాండిల్, లెంగ్త్ ఆఫ్ ఈచ్ క్యాండిల్ బి LCM of 8 and 6 is 24. Let us suppose length of each candle be 24 centimeter. As given that two candles with same length, length of two candles are equal. So that the burning rates, let us find the burning rate. Burning rate, Mande Samardhya. So 24 centimeter length of candle can burn in 8 hour. Then per hour it can burn 3 centimeter. Similarly, 24 centimeter candle can burn in 6 hours. Per hour, it can burn 4 centimeter. Okay? Burning rate of second candle is more than the burning rate of first candle. Leave it. Let us suppose, after T hours, ratio of length of these two candles is 3:1. Let us suppose after T hours, ratio of length of these two candles in 3:1. Therefore, length of the first candle is 24 centimeter. In T hours, it can burn 3T centimeter. What is the remaining length of first candle? 24 centimeter minus 3T centimeter. As its burning rate is per hour is 3 centimeter. In T hours, it can burn 3T centimeter. So, remaining length is 24 minus 3T. Similarly, length of second candle is 24 centimeter. It can burn 4 centimeter per hour. In T hours, it can burn 4T centimeter. Remaining length of the second candle is 24 minus 4T. After T hours, the ratio of length of these two candles must be 3:1. By cross multiplication, 1 into 24, minus 1 into 3t, 3t equaled 3 into 24, minus 3/4 are 12t. So 12t minus 3t, that is 9t equaled 324 minus 24, that is 2 into 24. 3 threes are 3 eights are, that is t equaled 2 eights are 16 by 3 hours. T is in hours. 16 by 3 hours means 3 fives are 15 hours plus remaining 1 by 3 hour. Okay, 5 hour, 1 by 3 hour means 20 minutes. 1 by 3 hour, 1/3 of an hour is 20 minutes. That is answer is 5 hour 20 minutes. After the start of burning, 5 hours 20 minutes, the ratio of their length will be in the ratio 3:1. Okay, next most important question. A man ordered 4 pairs of black socks and some pairs of brown socks. 4 pairs of black and some pairs of brown. The price of a black pair is double to the brown pair. While preparing the bill, the clerk made the mistake and interchanged the number of black and brown pairs. Due to this, there is a 50% increase in the bill. The ratio of the number of black and brown pairs of socks in the original order was. Okay. ఒక వ్యక్తి 4 జతల నలుపు రంగు socks మరియు కొన్ని జతల గోధుమ రంగు సాక్స్ కు ఆర్డర్ ఇచ్చాడు. ఒక జత నలుపు సాక్స్ ధర ఒక జత గోధుమ సాక్స్ ధరకు రెట్టింపు. కానీ నలుపు గోధుమ జతల సాక్స్ లను తారుమారు చేసి బిల్ రూపొందించడం వలన ధరలో 50% పెరుగుదల జరిగింది. అయినా ఆ వ్యక్తి ఆర్డర్ చేసిన నలుపు కామ గోధుమ రంగు సాక్స్ జతల నిష్పత్తి ఎంత? సొల్యూషన్, వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ క్వశ్చన్. దీస్ ఆర్ బ్లాక్ సాక్స్, దీస్ ఆర్ బ్రౌన్ సాక్స్. He ordered 4 pairs of black socks and let us suppose he ordered x pairs of brown socks. Then what is the original bill? Original bill. What since the price of black pair is double to that of brown pair. Suppose 1 pair of brown socks is 1 rupee. Then 1 pair of black socks must be 2 rupee as it is double to the brown pair. Then what is the original bill? 4 2s are 8 rupees plus x 1s are x rupees. So 8 plus x rupees are original bill. Then what is the increased bill? What is increased bill? Increased bill is that since the pails are interchanged, the pails are interchanged. So, four pails of brown pails and x pails of black pails. Then, what is the increased bill? Total bill is x into 2, 2x rupees plus 4 ones are 4. This is increased bill in rupees. But finally, the amount is increased by 50%. What is the fraction value of 50%? 1 by 2. If 2 units is original and 1 unit is increased. So, original bill is 2 units. Then increased bill is 2 plus 1, 3 units. Okay. Now, consider the ratio. Original is 2 units, increased is 3 units. 3 times of 8 plus x, 3x are 24 plus 3x is equal to 2x plus 4 of 2 times, 2 2s are 4x plus 2 4s are 8. 4x minus 3x equal to x, 24 minus 8 equals 16. X equal to what? 16. We have to find the number of black pails and brown pails socks in original order. The original order, they are in ratio 4 is to x. That is 4 is to x value is 16. 1 is to 4 is the original ratio. So answer is C. Next and last problem of part 26 of ratio proportion. Okay. 30th problem. A and B have to write 810 and 900 pages respectively in the same time period. But A completes his work 3 hours ahead of time. And B completes 6 hours ahead of time. How many pages did A write per hour? If B wrote 21 pages more in each hour. Okay. A mari B lu okay kala vyavadhi lo 810 mari 900 pages rayavalsi untundi. Kani A tanu poorthi cheyalsina samayaniki 3 gantala munde poorthi chesestadu. మరియు బి తను పూర్తి చేయవలసిన సమయానికి 6 గంటల ముందే పూర్తి చేసేస్తాడు. బి ప్రతి గంటకు ఏ కన్నా 21 పేజీలు ఎక్కువ రాసినచో ఏ గంటకు ఎన్ని పేజీలు రాస్తాడు? ఇంపార్టెంట్ క్వశ్చన్. సొల్యూషన్ ఏ హాస్ టు రైట్ 810 పేజెస్ అండ్ బి హాస్ టు రైట్ 900 పేజెస్ అండ్ గివెన్ దట్ A write, we have to find how many pages did A write per hour if B wrote 21 pages more in each hour. Let us suppose A can write X pages per hour. Then B can write X plus 21 pages per hour. As B wrote 21 pages more in each hour than A. Right. So the time difference between A completed his work 3 hours ahead of time and B completes his work 6 hours ahead of time. The time difference is 3 hours. Time difference is 3 hours. The time taken by A to complete 810 pages, that is 810 by X hours. The time taken by B to complete 900 pages is 900 by X plus 21 hours. Their time difference is equal to what? 3 hours. From this we can get a quadratic equation, but which is lengthy process. Let us check it by options. Suppose these are the pages for A and these are the pages for B. Suppose A writes 45 pages per hour, then B can write 21 pages more, that is 66. But 66 means 11 6 are. In 66, there is a prime number 11. 11 cannot divide 900 completely. So, this is not answer. Let us go through second option. Suppose A can write 72 pages per hour. Then B can write 21 pages more, 93. Yes, 93 means 3 times of 31. Where 31 is a prime number. 31 cannot divide 900. So, 93 also cannot divide 900. So, this is not the answer. Let us go through option C. Suppose A can write 54 pages per hour. Then B can write 21 pages more. That is 75. Yes, 75 can divide 900 completely. Let us see. 810 by X equal 54 minus 900 by x plus 21 is 75. Yes, 900 can be written as 9200. 96 are 990s are 61s are 615s are 25 threes are 25 fours, 3 ones, 3 threes, 3 fours are 12. 15 minus 12 is 3 hours. So the option C, 54, satisfies the given equation. Satisfies this equation. So answer is C. That is, A writes 54 pages per hour. Okay. Yes. This completes the part 26 of ratio and proportion, as well as the chapter ratio and proportion is also completed. Okay, students, we will meet next in profit and loss chapter. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for watching my videos.